Starting. Hey everyone, welcome back to the next segment and one more interesting episode of Billennium Diva Show. I'm your host, Shubhangi Mitra. You are here, my friends, because you believe that the human potential is nearly limitless. But you know that having potential is not the same as doing something with it. So our goal with this show and the platform is to introduce you to the influences and ideas that will help you actually execute on your dream. Please stay tuned until the end. At the end of this interview, I'll be making one big announcement about Billennium Diva Show. As you all know, the Billennium Diva Show is a platform to look at stories, inspiration, and journeys of exceptional women entrepreneurs. It is an honest effort to bring out the best stories, inspiration, and the best motivation. Today, we have one such amazing guest with us, Ms. Aditi Gupta. And I'm really delighted to have her with us today. Welcome, Aditi.
Thank you so much, Shubhangi. Thanks to you and Bhavesh for, you know, giving me this opportunity to be on this platform. And I'm sure this platform is bound to be very, very successful because you are definitely making it worth to have these episodes with influencers and women entrepreneurs who have made a mark in the industry. So congratulations to you for the beginning of this, and let's see how it grows in future.
Well, I'm quite excited, Aditi, myself, trust me. So let me quickly give you a brief background on what our diva Aditi does. It is truly inspiring. Aditi, born and brought up in Mumbai, is passionate about turning her dreams into reality. After spending 10 years abroad, turning every opportunity into dream project, she is a proud owner of Mrs. India UK, first pioneer trademark pageant for Indian married women running in its successful fifth year. Professionally, she is a banker and social media and digital marketing specialist. Her portfolio adds being a Formula 4 racer, founder Mrs. India UK, winner Mrs. India Singapore Expat 2015, Mrs. Singapore finalist 2013, national and international pageant coach and director and runway model over the past few years in Singapore and London. Aditi Gupta, founder Mrs. India UK, Brand Walk, Pentagram Pictures, also a pageant coach, mentor, banker, is on the Billennium Diva Show to unfold the journey on a topic, unfolding life on a fast lane from crowning glory to entrepreneurship, mentoring success. So welcome, Aditi. We will begin the interview, and I'm truly honored. Trust me, I was looking forward for this interview for a very long time and couldn't have missed on this one. So I'll start my first question. Having donned several hats at leadership positions to becoming an entrepreneur, what has been your learning curve?
I think one of the biggest learnings for me is that you should never forget from where you have come. So staying grounded and down to earth and being humble and modest is something which I genuinely believe that, because success and failure is a part of your journey and your learnings. But something which is very close to you is being yourself. So that is something which I feel, you know, staying true to yourself really, really differentiates from a lot of characteristics that many people would have. People change over a period of time when you move from one journey to another. But thankfully, I think my parents have played a very key role in this, that, you know, however far you go, but make sure that you know your roots, where you come from, and stay polite and humble and modest as always. So that is something which, of course, has been installed in my mind very much.
I mean, yeah, indeed. As an entrepreneur, you have changed lanes and started Mrs. India UK, first pioneer trademark pageant for Indian married women. Now, there are 1,000 pages that happen all over the world, and I mean, what drove you towards this wonderful idea, Mrs. India UK? Can you tell me about it, please?
It's been a long time that, you know, I made a move from India to Singapore, then from Singapore to London. And one thing I realized that I have met so many accomplished women in this pageant journey. And this is one segment where people are not really noticing the efforts that each and every woman puts. It's not just, you know, a glamour quotient that is there, but there is a transformational journey that needs to be adapted and that needs to be showcased. And along with that, the kind of women I have come across in my personal journey, as well as while, you know, starting Mrs. India UK, is that the belief that you have the capability of being a leader, you have a capability of being a public speaker, and often that is being missed out. So when I started my journey, it was for a very different reason. For me, of course, I was looking on the both sides. One was, you know, I was doing modeling. I wanted to be a commercial artist or maybe explore opportunities as an actress or maybe small commercial advertisements and all, which I was doing simultaneously. And another part was that this was kind of a personal development ideology that, yes, you can join various classes, you can do a lot of ample things on your own, but under one roof, if you get a package where you get to learn not just makeup, catwalk, and the glamorous part, what people and the world believes as far as the pageant goes far. But in this, I believe that, you know, there is this kind of a one level up towards your confidence, another step up towards your leadership capability. Then social work is one crucial aspect where I was actually driven to also. And then that there was this part where, you know, you get an opportunity to actually be on stage and speak to so many people. You become the voice of a certain cause, or you become the voice of your own dreams. That's something which actually drove me to launch Mrs. India UK. And on the personal front, of course, this was a dedication to my parents because they had supported me during my pageant journey a lot. And fortunately, I have my partner who also supported me towards this journey. Okay, so they have seen the kind of evolved person I am as not just, not just how I look from day one to till now, however I changed in my appearance and all. But also there are a lot of aspects which went ahead with me, along with me, and as I have grown as a person and as an individual. And secondly, why Mrs. India UK? Because I think there is always, I come from a background where, you know, I have Navy officers, Deputy Police Commissioner, Income Tax Officers, doctors, professionals and all. And staying abroad, I feel that India is always closer to your heart, you know, however you go, wherever you go, but that Indianness does not go away from you. And it was a very simple thought that if it has to be a name, it has to be for Indian married women. And that's the reason why I kept it very simple, Mrs. India UK, because there was no such platform. And fortunately, we were the pioneer trademark pageants over there, which went well. And now we are in the fifth season.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, well, it's an amazing platform. I have experienced it myself. So it is. Indeed, I have seen myself not only running it in its fifth year, but the transformation that women have gone through. And if you really see before and after results, they are really amazing. I mean, as I know myself for the last 3 to 4 years, the kind of, divas, those have shined on the international platform, the transformation journey is truly amazing. So congratulations on changing the lives of many, many women, including myself. So going further, we have come to a totally different field now, Aditi, motorsport. I mean, you are a Formula 4 racer as well, and you are also promoting women's sports. Whereas in motor racing, it's not very popular sport for women in India. What motivated you to turn towards racing?
So I think a few years back before I moved abroad, I was always on my bike. I was always, enjoying my rides on bike. And I have probably, I have experienced almost all the bikes that are there on Indian roads, maybe Bullet or any other, sports bike. I have actually being fortunate that I had friends who had some high-end bikes, and I have tried myself on that as well. So this was something which I used to enjoy since beginning. And But motorsports never actually is something which never came to my mind. I only remember a few years back that, you know, in India, I remember they started this go-karting. So I had experienced go-karting, but then there was no level ahead about it. When I came over here and I came across social media, I saw that there is something which is Formula 4. And being a fan of Formula 1, I always wondered, how do these women enter? How do these women actually go and all? And fortunately, now that, you know, there are teams which are actually accepting entries for the women drivers also. So they are not segregating it as a women motorsports and all, but you get a chance and get an opportunity, equal opportunity with men. And there are some superb, amazing drivers along with me also. But it's an experience in itself. So I think the bike riding, loving to, you know, drive a car, and it just came into you just connected the dots and you knew that, okay, this is something which you would, you know, challenge yourself with, and this is something which you would want to do it. Little late, but I felt it's a good opportunity to learn. It's a good opportunity to at least promote these motorsports, because I think there are ample women over here I see nowadays driving beautiful cars, riding bullets and really Harley Davidson and all. And I feel they are the right audience. But unless someone actually speaks about it, the reachability is still going to be very minimal, you know. And that's the reason why I thought that probably might as well, you know, I take a step ahead and start promoting about motorsports. And you never know, we might have an amazing driver coming soon.
Yeah. Well, it's a truly interesting. I mean, preparation and everything, it is not a very easy task. And so congratulations on that one. Another crown, I must say, that apart from your passion crown. One more thing, you have been awarded as one of the youngest achievers in your community and commended for your work in several areas. What are your next goals that you have set forth to achieve?
I think currently I'm looking forward to promote as much as anything that challenges women and breaks the myth of, you know, having a particular status quo, saying that, okay, this is the age, this is the height, this is the weight. So like, you know, that Mrs. India tagline, Mrs. India UK tagline itself is, you know, breaking the myth of, you know, actually redefining the myth of beauty. It's something that you want to break the myth of people having so much of judgment about the women. And I think that is my ultimate goal, because I want to explore in all areas where there should be accomplished women coming forward, or there should be this young generation who should be stepping up, because there is now an exposure to everything. Unlike from the way we have grown, probably there was a limitation, then the internet started, you know, the Google came in, there's so much of things happening at the same time. But right now the generation is having it all. They just need to identify what is their talent and skills. And the more we speak about it, and especially a woman speaks about it, the more they will hear about it. So I feel that the younger generation should take it from our generation, that there are various aspects. At the same time, I feel women like me who are married, you know, for whatever number of years, having kids and all, they should not have this kind of a mindset that my dreams or passion has ended or my learning capability has ended somewhere. I feel there is always an opportunity lying there to revive yourself, to rediscover yourself, you know, to re-energize yourself. It might be for a hobby, it might be for an experience, it might be actually for a career also. I think that is very, very essential in today's world, to develop yourself in a constant phase of evolvement. So that is what I'm trying. I'm mainly focusing on what can we promote towards women and upliftment, or probably something which I won't say empowers them. I always believe each woman is empowered enough and she is an accomplished woman.
Yeah.
I just feel that she just needs sort of a positive environment and pushing the boundaries, which I think jointly we can do it.
Yes. Well, that's a wonderful thought. And I know you have been you know, working in all aspects, and it is not only just women, but associating with a lot of charities nationally and internationally. So that is truly great to know. So we had asked our audience to send a few questions, and trust me, the questions have poured in. I could not take all of them, but yes, there are few I have chosen. So these are the questions from our audience. Aditi, what do you do to stay motivated?
I think my funda is very simple. Mm. I believe in gratitude.
Yeah.
I think that is something which gives a content at the end of the day. Secondly, I try to eliminate myself from the negative forces. We cannot deny the fact that, you know, we are poured with challenges, we are poured with struggles, we are poured with negativity all across, whether, you know, it might be family, it might be professional life, it might be business, it might be any competition, anywhere you go. So these are the two, you know, kind of things that coming and keep pouring. But you need to first, you know, be mentally strong that, you know, how you should be eliminating all these forces that drive you to distract. Mm-hmm. So I try not to distract myself. I have very clear thoughts in my mind. If it is yes, if I want to do something, then I focus towards that and I try to achieve those goals. And self-motivation for me is talking to the right people.
Mm-hmm.
Creating a right environment around me, which in turn inspires me and influences me. And also a lot of appreciation and the compliments that I receive, they, you know, quite boost my energy in return, honestly, because I am so overwhelmed for each and every stage in my life for past 10 years being abroad. It has never been an easy journey. It's not an easy journey, but the kind of people I have met has been fabulous. I'm, you know, thankful that till date I have some amazing, amazing friends, amazing finalists and amazing queens that keep motivating. I keep watching your work. Like, you know, Shubhangi, you have been so much an inspiration to many of us because the way we had our sessions, the way change happened, and now, you know, you're a host. And I think this was one of your dreams as well. So when I see that, I think I personally also feel motivated that yes, somewhere, you know, a woman at any stage in life can do much more if she decides to. Yes. So I think
that's very inspiring, Aditi. And I hope you stay motivated and keep motivating many people like me and millions after you. So the next question is, what is the lesson that you think is most important for a new entrepreneur to learn and why? Because see, this specific question I have chosen is in last year, 10 years, you are quite young to handle so many companies and being an entrepreneur. And still, when person starts one company, they focus on it, embrace it. And like 5 to 10 years, their focus is just on that one company. But I keep on seeing that you have different projects and you do so many things. So what is that, important thing you want to tell the entrepreneur that they can be successful in their ventures and they should learn before they get into it and why?
If I have to consider today's world, if I have to consider today's fast-paced world, I would say networking is something that they really, really need.
Yeah.
Okay. If they want to, if they stick to their own mind and if they stick to their own idea, I believe that yes, it works. But till the time, you know, you go and network and talk to people about your ideas, take a very constructive feedback, unless that, you don't know where you're heading. So to have that right direction, networking is very important. Talking to the right mentors, talking to the, you know, right people who can guide you towards that journey becomes very essential in your research part itself.
Mm-hmm.
Secondly, I think you need a lot of resilience and patience also, because it's not going to be an easy journey. Mm-hmm. Entrepreneurship is never an easy journey. Even people who leave corporate life and join entrepreneurship and all, it takes time to absorb everything. That monthly you're not going to get salary, but you have to drive yourself to reach that goal, okay, and keep continuing on those steps that, okay, someday I will fall, someday I will, you know, have 2-3 steps more, someday I will be walking 2 steps behind. So there are many aspects, but you need that resilience and patience, and you just need to be a bit stronger in your mind.
Mm-hmm.
A third thing is, you know, I have seen a lot of people advise a lot of people. Okay, yeah. When you come with an idea, there will be so many advisors as if they have done it, they have been there, they have, you know, there, or there would be always some kind of a energy which would say, you know, this is not happening, you know, you should think about it, why don't you go back? Mm. Being an entrepreneur in itself is not easy, okay? Yeah. And if anyone, even I am amazed the kind of home entrepreneurs are, which, you know, even do small, like, smallest part. I have seen organic products coming in. I have seen a lot of makeup products, cosmetic products being launched. I have seen a lot of tech companies coming up, or say even a small, I have seen the fragrance soaps and all. So being a home entrepreneur is also not easy because you're juggling. An entrepreneur has to have that strength to juggle into multiple roles because you are not going to have each and every one around you as a team. In the first stage. Yeah. So the first stage, as we call, you know, it's a teething stage for a startup where there are going to be people, there are going to be people leaving you. There are going to be people who are going to be amazed by you. There are going to be people who are going to be jealous by you. There are going to be people who will, you know, be so positive towards you. There'll be people who would just be negative, but then you have to keep your focus on. Yeah. So I think the third thing which is like goes with it is the focus. Mm-hmm. Okay. Hear everything. Okay. But don't consume it so much that it distracts you from what you want to achieve.
Yeah.
Okay. Because you need to have that gut feeling. You need to have that intuition why you want to do this.
Mm.
And I think you are the only person who 100% knows what and why you are there. Yeah. So if you can answer what, why, how, okay. I think then you are in the right, say, but right stage, but yes, you need ample focus to actually drive that journey.
Yeah.
For me, what I did was why I actually ventured out into multiple projects or the companies and all is because of my background.
Yeah.
Okay. So I come, of course, I'm a postgraduate in event management, which helps me to do a detailed event management. And I enjoy that. I enjoy being with people, around people. I have, you know, done branding and strategy. So it was just a, it was just an immersive environment for me that, okay, I like events. I like branding and strategy. Okay. I like photography. I like production.
Yeah.
Okay. So how do I just integrate all of this to kind of prepare my own ecosystem?
Of course.
And at the same time, I met quite great people like, you know, I met Anshika and Pradnya and we started the Career Catalyst program, which helps women to actually prepare their CVs and be presentable, help them with the interview skills, prepare their LinkedIn profile and make them the market ready, whether they are on the job at the moment or they are not on the job, okay, at the moment. But then it gives them strength. So we did conduct these Career Catalyst program also in UK for some time. And then, you know, of course, Pradnya is moving forward with other ventures as well. And Shika has moved to Singapore. But this was one venture which was very close to our heart. And we will kind of revive that also because we believe in today's world, transferable skills are also acceptable. So that is something which was one of the focus for that. And another Pentagram Pictures is, of course, because me and my husband both love photography. We love production. I'm well versed with creative platforms that are there. And that was one of the aims that, okay, we should also slowly, you know, kind of construct something which supports our passion and as well as the interest also.
Yeah.
So for me, business per se, yes, everybody wants to have profit. Everybody wants to earn money. Everybody wants to have it all.
Mm-hmm.
For me, it is a balance of, say, passion and as well as a balance of what leads you to the journey over a period of time. And it is something where I feel Mrs. India UK just made it at a different level. It was a completely different level to what I was doing and with brand work, actually. And brand work was kind of an established company in Singapore, and when I landed in UK, we thought, okay, fine, I'll start up with the pageant. So it was a little reverse journey for me. While I could have just gone ahead and started something in branding, digital marketing, social media, content writing and all, but at the same time I felt, why is there no pageant at all? Because I come from a pageant background. I saw many women in UK And I thought that this platform would be the right one to actually get these accomplished and achievers in London together, UK together, and make it big. And this is how it is. And probably this is why we are lucky to now, you know, run in the fifth season.
Yeah, that is true. I mean, wow, that's amazing, Aditi. So I hope our viewer has got their answer that what you need to do, learn, and why. Some interesting tips truly to implement for our new entrepreneurs. Aditi, very interesting question. What is that X factor in you, you think has most contributed towards your success? I want to know.
X factor. What is that
one factor in you, you think has most contributed towards your success? See the questions that have come from the audience. I mean,
honestly, I don't think so. I have any X factor as such. Sometimes you don't get time to actually, you know, see through yourself.
Yeah. But if you have to name that one factor in you that has contributed towards your success.
Okay, X factor. It's very, honestly, this answer is very, very difficult for me to actually answer, because maybe other people might say or say something that, okay, what is in me that drives me? I think X factor, I'm still unable to answer. Honestly, I'm still unable to answer. I just don't know what is it. It is just...
I think you have too many, so it is difficult to name. So whoever has asked this question, you need to really follow Aditi. You will find your... There is not one factor that I can name or even she can name.
I believe is... I have a very composed mind, and I have a very, very composed mind. I have a very clear thoughts in what I want to do and how I want to go ahead with it. Mm-hmm. I don't kind of complicate things for me. I am very much stay simple, and that allows me to do something different every time I look up that, okay, what's next for me? Mm-hmm. Okay, so I think that composed mind helps me to actually see through what not many people would see, and that helps me to drive my journey towards my personal goals. That's it. Yeah,
well, that's interesting. Hope whoever has asked has found the answer. I'm not satisfied with it, because you have many, as I said. One more interesting question is, see, you have two beautiful children, okay, and you are also very efficient. I have seen the family time, you quality time you spend with your family and your children, and beautiful, beautiful children. How do you balance your entrepreneur's life? As I said again, it's not one project. There are so many, and simultaneously being a successful entrepreneur in many ventures, maintaining your hobbies as well, and then looking after your family. So how do you balance your entrepreneur's life with your personal life?
I think my mind is like compartmentalized. Okay. That I have this particular time. I have to make the best of it for what I'm doing. Mm-hmm. Then it moves to another section. And then, okay, now I'm a mom. Now I better make my time and make most of my time in, you know, enjoying the kids or letting them explore a little bit different. So this is what I'm trying to do with Ariana, who is my daughter. Okay. So she gets to see me, because I have been inspired by mom. You know, I've seen her working hard. Somewhere I feel all of us moms should take that responsibility to give an opportunity to our daughters to see how it is. Mm-hmm. The younger one is just 1 year, so he just clings on to me, and I have no escape at all. So I just carry on with it. So, but yes, I kind of... I would say there is a clarity for me with regards to the time management, and that helps me. I know what to prioritize and when to prioritize. I am okay to have less and do more of what I would prefer to do. So I don't get greedy with things around me that, you know, if I have something, then I'll go for more for it or anything. If I'm satisfied with one, I'm satisfied with one thing at a time. And I do not overload myself with too many things. And at the same time, I cannot deny the fact that it is because of Prashant, who is my husband, thoroughly I appreciate. I can never ever thank him enough for the way he has stood by me in each and every challenge that I have taken. He very well knows that I can't sit idle. I need to have multiple hats juggling all the time. And he supports it. He blends with this idea. He accepts the fact that, yes, Aditi is someone who would, you know, not be someone who would just sit idle and do nothing, but she'll always come up with some of the other ideas, or either traveling, whether it's launching a new project, or just writing a concept notes. I write a lot of idea concept notes, which I don't release, of course. For my records, but I do come up with a lot of multiple projects, which maybe in the future, when I decide to, and you know, when I think it's the right time, I do launch it. At the moment, I am focusing on my work, and of course, Miss India UK is always there, close to my heart. So, focusing on two things at the moment, but the work-life balance for me is because of Prashant and my kids. My daughter is very much aware about my schedule, okay? And she always appreciates that. And she's always proud to talk about what her mom is doing. So that helps me. That helps me a lot. And there are always weekends, right? You can always take a break sometimes, ignoring everything and enjoy with the family.
But that doesn't seem to be, because see, we are doing our interview on the weekend itself. So even you know how to balance.
I did spare time with my family. I did spare time with my family. And then I'm like, okay, I have to be with Shubhangi, so no disturbance anymore. See, that's the time management skill.
Honored, I've been Aditi. I know how difficult it has been, like, to get hold of you for last few days and all. But this is wonderful to hear how you balance all aspects of your life and still an inspiration, not failing anywhere at all. I mean, I have witnessed it. So, last question: that one message that you would want to give to all our wonderful divas across the globe.
I think one message that I would, you know, honestly give to everyone is live life to the fullest. Yeah. You know, you have one life, you know, it's a beautiful life. There are ample times you can complain about it, but why not compliment your life? Yeah. And if you start appreciating and complimenting your life, you know, I think you will be able to be happy at the end of the day. Yeah. So I think just live your life the way it is, the way you love to. Don't take the burden of too many things. And those who wish to be entrepreneurs or be successful career women and all, just go for it. Everything falls in place when the right time comes. So they don't have to, you know, stick back to something. They should just keep going ahead and moving forward.
Well, that was truly, truly delightful. And that's the end of our interview. I mean, thank you so much, Aditi, for taking the time. I thoroughly enjoyed our interview, and I was especially pleased to learn more about how you have been so successful in managing so many challenging roles as an entrepreneur, mentor, international pageant coach, banker, model, Formula 4 driver, and the secret formula to success of Aditi. Is there anything that you can't do, Aditi?
I mean, there's a lot. There is a list, like I say, and tell all my friends or whoever come, there's a list.
Yeah.
And but I'm definitely not going to achieve it this life, but I will try to.
Here you are. It is truly admirable how you always see projects through from conception to completion. And on behalf of Millennium Divas, thank you for speaking your heart. We are grateful for the time and effort you took to share your thoughts and experiences with Millennium Divas. Thank you so, so much, Aditi.
My pleasure. Thank you so much. It was really wonderful interacting and answering questions. Something different that I could also speak about. And thanks to you and Bhavesh for running this platform. I think it's amazing. And I wish you all the success in the coming year. And I'm looking forward for more influencers and inspirational women entrepreneurs coming on this platform. Okay. Thank you so much, Ryan.
Thank you. Thank you so much. So after this power-packed interview with our international diva, Aditi, the time has come for big announcement. Here we go. Announcing the launch of Women Power Summit and Awards 2021. Coming this May 21, organized by Billennium Divas Women Empowered Group, Women Power Summit and Awards 2021, or WPSA 21, is a highly curated and process-driven recognition platform for women entrepreneurs across 30 plus different categories. It promises to recognize and felicitate women entrepreneurs, investors, mentors, incubators, accelerators, government bodies, and ecosystem enablers across the industry spectrum for their greed and determination, fighting all odds and in bringing change and growth, thereby making it a merit-based recognition in its true sense. WPSA 2021 brings together women lead co-founded startups, entrepreneurs, mentors, investors, and thought leaders from all walks of life to share their enriching journey and experience at this platform. We are inviting speakers, partners, and sponsors, and ecosystem players to join us to be a part of this fabulous initiative in supporting more women entrepreneurs in our country. Opportunity for selected startups to pitch the investors for funding, and top three selected startups to win amazing prizes, and many more. To know more, reach out to me or join the group or find the details in the description box. So here, I'm your host, Shubhangi Mitra, signing off for today. Thank you. Thank you.